did too, but I thought I'd make a video because I thought of another reason why I don't usually wear makeup in my videos. It's because it takes too long. And by the time I get done showering and getting dressed, like, I'm so exhausted I could probably go back to sleep. I know a lot of disabled people watch this channel, so I have a question for you guys. Does showering exhaust you too? Like, and getting dressed. I put a thing on Facebook one time about, like, getting dressed is the hardest part of the day. And somebody was like, no, it's not. But, you know, that person obviously isn't disabled, because I'm here to tell you what. Like, getting dressed is a workout. I wish it would be working the parts of my body I want to work out, but maybe it is. Like, it's probably working all of me out. But anyway, it's exhausting. And now I was thinking about putting makeup on, but before I do that, I'm going to blow dry my hair. Like, see how dry it already is getting? So I just got dressed after the shower. And it took me so long to get dressed that my hair is actually almost dry already. But I want to dry it straight, so I might have to wet it down a little bit more and then blow dry it straight. But anyway, okay, I'm gonna pause this. I'll be back. I'm gonna blow dry my hair. Okay, I'm back. Another thing I was thinking about is, see, what's up with that? Like, I just washed my hair. Why does it look greasy? Tell me. Another thing I wanted to mention is that, when you're feeling bad, okay, so I said, yeah, taking a shower is exhausting, which it is. Getting dressed is exhausting, which it is. But, and this is why a lot of people, I think, who are in bad medical conditions, we don't take showers maybe as often as regular people. We don't get dressed as often as people without disabilities because it is so exhausting. However, the other day I was feeling really sick, and I, finally, like, I had avoided taking showers for a couple days because I had felt so sick and stuff, but then finally I took a shower, brushed my teeth really good, stuff like that. It's really important for your well-being. Like, I've felt better ever since that first shower, and, you know, so, yeah, it's exhausting, it's frustrating, it sucks, but, sometimes what you need to really kick yourself out of a funk is a good shower. A good session of brushing your teeth. Some people meditate, some people pray, etc. All those things I think are really good. I believe in the power of music too. So when I'm feeling bad, sometimes I just crank my music up really loud and go out and dance to sad songs or whatever. I can cry dance, can you? Anyway, and my style of dancing, by the way, just in case you see me around town, I just car dance. I do what you do in your car, except in my wheelchair. And so I'm like, woohoo, rocking out, yeah, saying I love you, to all these, like, whenever the song says it, I say it, so hopefully, you know, nobody takes it too personally. Alright, I'm gonna... Oh, yeah, I was going to use the makeup while I'm making a video. Fine. Gotta find the makeup. I put it in this little bag so that it's all easy access. And the other day, I ran over this tube. So the white stuff is all splattered out. But, oh well, that's the story of my life. I ran over so much stuff. It's not even funny. Sometimes I even run over stuff on purpose, but if I pay attention, then I can kind of straddle it with my wheels so I don't destroy as much stuff. But, yesterday I got so stuck, in my doorway because I had all this stuff I wanted to take to charity. And so I piled my lap up with all this stuff. And then, you know, I was trying to get out the door. Well, when I pushed the door open, there was a hairbrush that had been caught kind of underneath where the thing, where the door went. And so anyway, it was making the door stickier than it usually is. It took me, like, literally about, I don't know, at least 10 minutes to get out of the door and then shut it behind me. So, these are yet more reasons why it takes me so long. Yeah, I don't know. I don't, like, sometimes when I put makeup on, I feel like it really doesn't change much. Like, I mean, I don't want to wear really heavy makeup, and I try not to, but so that's probably why it doesn't make this dramatic change. But still, like, sometimes I even wonder, why do I even put it on at all? But you know, it does disguise my red spots. I have started to avoid putting it on my wrinkles because it just gets caked in them and makes them even more dramatic than they already are. But anyway, so one of the reasons I realized that I have wrinkles in my hand is because, like, I squint a lot. I used to, especially because I didn't wear hats all over town, but now I wear a lot of hats, so I don't squint as much, but still. Oh, yeah, and I said I wasn't going to put makeup on, but it kind of looks like maybe there's a little bit right there. I don't know. Oh, well. Okay, so that's the concealer part, and then I should get some blush. Like, I want to get some cream blush because it's really easy to put on and stuff, and but I keep forgetting when I go to the store to look for it. This blush really isn't, like, my top priority, but I'm pretty pale, so I probably would benefit from some. It's weird trying to do your makeup in a camera instead of a mirror. Like, I don't know. It's kind of working. So usually I get the mascara that is, like, CoverGirl in the orange thing, that volume one, and it might, like, see that? After I just put concealer on. Now. Great. 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 I don't know what I'm doing. It's weird. I kind of feel like I need to pee. Hold on. Hey, I was totally right. I did need to pee. Peed in the toilet. Woohoo! Not in my diaper, although I am wearing one today because I'm gonna go shopping for my son. And I moved the camera up because I still haven't actually pulled pants up, and I don't want to, like, show anything too graphic here. But I'm gonna attempt to get redressed now. That's the bad thing. Okay, I'm back again. Still trying to pull up my pants. Got a phone call from Medical Supply Guy. He's gonna come out here in a little bit to get me to sign a paper that I didn't sign yet, apparently. So, anyway, now it's even more important that I get my pants up since I'm going to have a little bit of company. But, they're coming slowly but surely. How do you get your pants up if you're in a wheelchair? Like, I use the armrests, but I have a friend who doesn't have armrests. He took them off because they got in his way and stuff. But anyway, he always transfers, like, onto the bed to pull his pants up, and that's what I did when I got dressed this morning. But I don't want to transfer back onto the bed right now because I want to stay in my chair and just finish getting ready so I can go out. the plan today is to go to the area around, like, one of my favorite parts of town. I'm going to look for some clothes for my teenage son for Christmas, and then maybe my daughter too, but probably not. I'm going to give her some of the clothes that Beth sent because we're about the same size now. It's funny when your kids start, like, wearing all your clothes and stuff when they're your same size. It's cool. I like it. I remember with my stepdaughter's first, I have three girls all together because I have two stepdaughters and then my biological daughter, but it's always cool when they start wearing my clothes. I don't know why. I just like it. I know some parents would probably get annoyed with it or whatever. Okay, I think I got my pants up. I'm gonna shut this down a little bit. And try to finish my mascara before that guy comes. But anyway, oh, also, you know how I was talking about I should get some blush because I'm so pale and stuff? See, this is really hard. It's hard to do it in a camera. I don't know why. It's the same thing as a mirror. It actually might even be a little bit better. But, I don't seem to be doing as good as I usually do with a mirror. Poking my eyes out. Whoops. Getting mascara all over my eyelids. Oh well. That'll have to work. Yep. I know. Oh man. Yeah. Forget about that. Close enough. Work, like, seriously, nobody's gonna notice whether or not I have a makeup on anyway. So, but yeah, I don't think I like this mascara as much as the CoverGirl volume and the orange bottle. That's my favorite so far. Oh wow, this one though, when I bought it, it came with like a little trial size. Free trial size one. So, hey, that was cool. Okay, but this is the other thing I was going to show you. You know how I was talking about I should get blush and all that. So, when the Halloween stuff went on sale, it was like 90% off at CVS. And I bought this. It's like pink glittery makeup that you can, you know, paint your face with or whatever. But I'm going to try using that. That's what I bought it for. It's like, this stuff is 90% off. I need to find a reason to get it. But, you know, I don't think it actually looks like not as blush. I mean, it's, like, too light for that, I think. Oh. It will work for me. It'll work for today. Blah, blah, blah. All right. That guy's going to be here pretty soon, so I'm going to end this video. And I am going to put on some of both of my signs fell off, so I need to put them back on, the signs that I'm going to have today. One of them says, I'll just show you. Boom. Boom. That's one of my signs for today, and I don't know what the other one will be, but